just my mom. Yeah, I was not saying that. That is Christian.
My grandpa had a great fighting spirit. He always said to life, "Oh life, there is a great joy in fighting with you. You never allow me to win, and I never accept my defeat." Good afternoon to the Toastmasters and distinguished guests. I was born in a joint family of 10 members in a small village of Ramgarh district in Jharkhand. I have two younger brothers. My grandpa was a farmer, and being a farmer, it was very difficult for him to feed his family. So my father and my uncles, they left their studies and started working on field with my grandpa. After the age of 13, my father never saw the face of school. When I grew a little older, my father was worried about my education. He wanted me to put me in English medium school, but the situation never allowed. But he had a great, I did my schooling from KB High School, Lari, and I scored very good marks in 10. So my father sent me to Hazaribagh to pursue my plus two. I got admission in St. Columbus College, Hazaribagh, one of the prestigious institute of our state. And my cousin told me, "Hey, you are good in studies, why don't you try for engineering?" I said, "Yeah, sure." And I started preparing for it. After the tuitions, I used to go to library for the self-studies. But there, I found my old love. Yeah, the storybooks. When I was in middle school, I used to read a lot of stories. Whenever I moved to a new class and used to get the new books, the very first thing I used to do is to grab the Hindi book. And I used to read all the stories within 2 to 3 days. And one day when I went to library, I saw a separate section in a shelf with a tag, Munshi Premchand. Yes, Munshi Premchand is my favorite writer. There were around 15 books. I read all those books in these 2 years. And I found the engineering entrance exam did not go well, but somehow I got admission in Gandhi Engineering College, Bhubaneswar. I did B.Tech from there. I was in fourth year and the placement season was over. I didn't have job in my hand, so I went to training and placement officer and I said, "Sir, रिटेन में अच्छा करने के बावजूद भी मेरा इंटरव्यू में सिलेक्शन क्यों नहीं हुआ?" He just gave a weird look and said, you speak 5 sentences in English and I'll get you placed." I put my head down and left from there. I had a pressure to get a job to support my family. I came to Bangalore just after college. I stayed there for 6 months and attended more than 40 off-campuses, but luck was not with me. On every failure, I remember my grandpa. I told myself, "Oh life, there is a different kind of joy in fighting with you. You never allow me to win, and I never accept my defeat." After a month, I got a job and moved to Chennai. My company's MD told that to all the freshers that, "Why you guys don't attend Toastmasters?" I came to Medley. When I entered, I saw the prize distribution was going on. I was surprised at what's happening. I took a chair and settled down. Then after a few minutes, I came to know that the meeting was in topsy-turvy format. Distinguished Toastmaster Alex was the TMOD that day. I soon joined Medley Toastmasters, and on October 2014, when I was delivering my CC1 speech, the old memories again made me nervous. When I was in 8th standard, I participated in inter-school speech contest, and when I went to the stage, I saw the 200, the eyes of 200 people was continuously looking at me. I got nervous, I fumbled and left the stage in middle. The same memories again hit back. But this time I told myself, oh life, it was a different kind of feeling in fighting with you. You never allow me to win and I never accept my defeat. Finally, I completed my speech in 11 minutes. Even though I was disqualified, but I had a satisfaction. And when I finished my speech, I went back and sat down. I said in my mind, oh life, this time I never let you win, and in future also I'll never allow you and never let you win again. So, thank you.